Hey there, I'm Conscious, and this video is video one of my 2D platformer series in Godot. In this first video, we're going to be building a solid foundation by setting up our project structure and creating basic character movement. All the assets that I'm going to use in this series are going to be from a user named AnsiMuzz on itch.io, and I'm going to link to these assets in the description of the video. I did make some tweaks to them though, so you can also download them from the GitHub link in the description. I'm going to be adding a new branch for each video, so you'll be able to see what the code is at the end of each video. All right, so let's get into it. So first, we're just going to set up our project structure, so it's going to make things easier down the road. You can see I've already imported all of the assets here, so you'll need to do that as well. These are most of the assets that we're going to be using throughout the entire series. But as I add more, you'll be able to find them here, or I will link them in the description as well. So first thing we're going to need to do is create our player scene. So right off the bat, we can just hit other node, and we're going to be using a character body 2D, which is the basic character setup for a 2D game. I'm going to rename the node to player, just to keep it a little bit easier. We are going to save it. I'm also going to create a new folder, call it scenes, and inside of scenes, I'm going to create another new folder and call it player. And that's where we're going to save our scene. So we have to add three additional nodes to our player in order to actually do anything with it. So if we hover over this exclamation point here, you'll see it doesn't have a collision shape. We don't even have a sprite. So the first thing we are going to do is add a sprite 2D node. We're also going to add an animation player, which is going to come in later. We're going to do that in a future video where we're actually adding in our animations. And then we're also going to add a collision shape 2D. We're still getting an error on the collision shape where we actually have to give it a shape, but we're going to worry about that after we already have our player. So we can now click back in to the sprite 2D, and we're going to be adding a new texture. Rather than doing it on the right side in the inspector panel, I am just going to go into my assets, into my characters, main, and I'm going to be using the male sprite sheet, so I can drag it here. This gives us the entire sprite sheet, so we do need to go into the animation, where it's going to be 6 frames vertically, and I believe 8. Is it 8? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep. 8 on the horizontal. Okay. I like to just drag it up to be kind of even on the X and Y axis. Let's just zoom in so we can make sure that we're kind of exactly there. You can see kind of right off the bat that our player looks a little blurry and not as crisp as you'd want to see with pixel art. So in order to save that, or to update that, we're going to go into the project settings, and we're going down to rendering and textures. The default texture filter is always set to linear, but for pixel art games, you're going to need to set it to nearest. When we close that, you can see that this looks much crisper and exactly what we're looking for out of a pixel art game. I am going to just change the default frame to be this idle frame. We'll work on all of the animations, like I said, in a future video. I'm just going to save this for now. We can go to our collision shape. I'm going to add a rectangle shape, which we are going to use this to detect collisions with the player. So, you know, he's not going to be able to fall through floors. It can detect enemies or items and stuff like that, which that's much further down the road. But we'll definitely get there. All right. And before we actually get to coding anything, we're going to set up some layers for our player and world in the future. So we're going to click on our character body 2D node. We're going to hit collision, and these are our collision layers and collision masks. The layers are what you are. The player is layer one, so that's what it is. It is on layer one. We are going to rename that to the player layer. So player is on layer one. The mask is what it looks for with collisions. What can it collide with? So we're going to just call layer 9 ground. Then we're going to go back into here. We don't have to do anything on the layer, but the mask is going to be on layer 9. So that's what we are going to collide with, but we are a player. All right. Now we want to click on this node here, the player node, and we're going to attach a script. We are going to use this template for the basic movement. We're going to make some changes to it, but it does give us a really good structure for our basic movement. And click create. So this is the basic movement for a character body 2D that comes standard with Godot. We can actually test this out. We are going to make some changes right now, but we are going to test this out right now so you can just see what it is. If I initially run this screen, you can see the gravity just immediately makes my player fall off the screen. That's why we need the collision shapes, and we're going to make an example platform so we can actually, you know, have him land on something rather than just fall infinitely. But if I do play it and use the arrow keys, which are these UI left and UI right, those are the standard Godot keys for the left and right key, and accept is the space bar. If I go replay this, hold the arrow keys, you can see I can move my player. He's still going to be falling because the gravity, and we aren't colliding with anything, but we can actually move him. So the things that I'm going to update is, first of all, I'm going to give it a class name of player. This allows us to access the player outside of just this script. We can access this class. And I am actually not going to use constants for speed and jump velocity. I'm going to use export variables for speed. I'm going to statically type it as a float for 200. And then I'm going to call gravity. I'm not going to use the default gravity here that Godot has. And I am going to also make this a float and put it at 980, which I believe is the default on the Y. But I want to be able to use export variables because then we can update them in the editor and get a live look on how our speed changes or our gravity changes affect the player. It also allows us to change them down the road if you want to enter a low gravity zone, if you want to speed up or slow down the player, you can access these variables and change their values. So I'm going to get rid of this. We aren't going to handle jump right now, so I'm going to get rid of the jump, get rid of these comments. Instead of get gravity, I'm going to call gravity. I'm going to get an error here though, because velocity is a vector 2 where it has x and y coordinates. We're only working on, you know, we're only going to be working on the y for gravity. So I'm just going to do velocity and access the y axis. You can see you might think that gravity is pulling you down. It should be a negative number, but in Godot, positive numbers on the y axis actually move down, or visually in the 2D space is moving us down. This direction is listening to our input. So when we are pressing the left, it gives us a negative 1, and we press right, it gives us a 1. So that's how we're determining our x, the direction that we're going to be moving. I'm going to make a small change to this though. I'm going to statically type it, direction, velocity.x. We are going to do speed and speed. So if we have a direction, we are applying the direction and multiplying it by our speed variable. So that's how we're choosing the direction that we want to go and how fast we're going. If we don't have a direction, which means we're not pressing a key and direction would be 0, we use this move toward function, which effectively acts as a deceleration component. So rather than us stopping on a dime at 0, it brings us to a stop slowly. We're also going to tweak this down the road, but just know that that's the purpose of that method. And then move and slide. Move and slide is what actually makes the player kind of apply the physics stuff that we're making and actually moves and slides the player. All right. Now we should create a test platform. So what I'm going to do is we're going to make a new scene. We're just going to make it a 2D scene, and we're just going to call this test scene. So we can save this. I'm just going to save it in our scenes folder. It's going to be our base scene that we're going to do a lot of this testing on. If we go here, you can see there's nothing here. So in order to add our player to the scene, we can click down here and find our player scene. Just drag it in here. Now we can see our player. I don't really want him up there though. I'm going to drag him somewhere in the middle just so we can see him. If we run this scene, you'll see a better picture of our player falling due to gravity out of the screen. So in order to give him a platform to collide on, we're going to add a child node. This is going to be a static body 2D. We'll just call it test platform. We're gonna end up getting rid of this later. We're going to call it a collision shape 2D. We have to add this node so it has something to collide with. We're going to click back into the test platform actually and set the collisions. So for this one, you don't want to be a player. We want to be the ground, and we're going to mask for the player so that we can actually find the player when it hits. In the collision shape 2D, we want to make a rectangle. I'm just going to bring it down here. I'm just going to extend this and let's save it. Let's run the scene. So now there's an invisible platform here, and I can move across the platform just like that. To kind of make it easier to visualize, if you want to go into the debug settings in the toolbar and hit visible collision shapes, this is a really helpful tool while you're debugging. So now if I click on this, I can actually see what he's colliding with. And now I can continue to just fall off, and that's our game. Pretty easy setup for the basic movement and character. In the next video, we are going to add jumping and add some improvements to our movement code. And we're also going to be getting into some of the animations so that the sprite flips when you're moving in different directions. And so it actually has some animations. We're going to be adding idle, jump, and run as well. All right, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments, and thanks for tuning in.